Baby, you understand me now. If sometimes you see that I'm mad, don't you know no one alive can always be an angel? When everything goes wrong, you see some bad. But I'm just a soul whose intentions are good. Oh Lord, please don't let me be misunderstood.
What's understood ain't gotta be explained. But you don't understand me, so let me explain. Stood in the heat, the flame, the snow. Please slow down, hurricane. The wind blow, my dread swing. He had hair like wool, like Wayne. Dropping ashes in the Bible. I shake them out and they fall on the rifle. Scary. Hail Mary, no tail fairy. All real, very extraordinary. Perry Mason facing the barrel if he tattle. My God is my judge. No gown, no gavel. A hound, a rabble. To battle now or never, or whenever, in the effort, fucking fantastic. Fuck if you agree, I'm bright, but I don't give a fuck if you see me.
I'm just a soul whose intentions are good. Oh Lord, please don't let me be misunderstood.
What's understood ain't gotta be explained. So for those who understand, meet Dwayne. For 8.5 months, I gave him a seat to pain. Now it's young money, baby, keep the change. And mama say, fuck him, and we the same. So hello, motherfucker, you got some sheets to change. And ain't it funny how people change like Easter Sunday? You know, church fit and outfit. Bright pink and green, just look house lit. Bright pinky rings, but that ain't about this. What you about, bitch? Excuse my French emotion and my passion, but I wear my heart on my sleeve like it's the new fashion. What are you asking? If I don't have the answer, it's probably on the web like I'm a damn tarantula. But I know you don't understand, cause you thought Lil Wayne was Weezy, but Weezy is Wayne.
I'm just a soul whose intentions are good. Oh Lord, please don't let me be misunderstood.
I watched the TV the other day, right? Got this white guy on there talking about black guys. Talking about how young black guys are targeted. Targeted by who? America. You see, one in every 100 Americans are locked up. One in every 9 black Americans are locked up. And see, what the white guy was trying to stress was that the money that we spend on sending a motherfucker to jail, a young motherfucker to jail, would be less to send his or her young ass to college. See, and another thing the white guy was stressing was that our jails are populated with drug dealers. You know, crack cocaine. Yeah. Stuff like that. Meaning, due to the laws we have on crack cocaine and regular cocaine, the police are only, I don't want to say only right, but shit, only logic by riding around in the hood all day and not in the suburbs. Because crack cocaine is mostly found in the hood. And, you know, the other thing is mostly found. You know where I'm going. But why bring a motherfucker to jail if it's not gonna stand up in court? Because this drug ain't that drug. You know, level 3, level 4 drug, shit like that. I guess it's all a misunderstanding. And, I sit back and think, well, shit, us young motherfuckers, you know, that 1 in every 9, we probably only selling the crack cocaine is because we in the hood. And it's not like the suburbs. We don't have the things that you have. Why?
I really don't want to know the answer. But I guess we just misunderstood, huh?
Yeah.
You know, we don't have room in the jail now for the real motherfuckers, the real criminals. You know, sex offenders, rapists, serial killers, shit like that. Oh, don't get scared. Don't get scared. I know you saw one of them sex offender papers. Don't trip. He live right on the end of your block. Mm-hmm. Yeah. That nigga live right down the street from you. Sex offender on the level 3 drug. Convicted. Ex-con. Yeah. Check him out. And hey, what you got? You got a daughter, son? What you got? Yeah. You know what? I'm down the track. That's the good weed. You know what? I have a fucking daughter. You understand me? And why the fuck would you bring my neighbor to jail just because the reason why he live next door to me ain't the reason why I live next door to him? Meaning, he didn't rap his way to my fucking neighborhood. He sold crack cocaine to get to my neighborhood. You move him out, bring him to jail for life. And then you move on to sex offender. They give me a paper. Is that a misunderstanding? Because I don't understand it. Another thing. Let me take my glasses off. Because I won't see the reaction on the faces when I say this. Mr. Al Sharpton. Here's why I don't respect you. And nobody like you. See, you're the type that gets off on getting on other people. That's not good, no homo. And rather unhuman, I should say. I mean, given the fact that humanity, well, good humanity rather, to me, is helping one another, no matter your color or race. But this guy and people like him, they'd rather speculate before they informate, if that's a word. You know, spec before check. Anyway, meaning, I'd much rather you talk to me first and see if you can lend an opinion before you make one. Just my thought of good humanity, Mr. Sharpton. Hold on, I ain't finished with you, man. I gotta pluck the ashes. Hold on. Mr. Sharpton, and anyone like you, you don't know me. So, if you're not gonna try to, then what you say or think about me, or whatever I do, is totally Casper the Friendly Ghost to me. And it doesn't make you a good person to criticize before you improvise. Doesn't necessarily make you a bad person either, but the characteristics fall heavily into bad sway. But since I am human, I am good and bad as well. But I try my hardest to stay good. And some of the things I do and say may be bad, or just not too good. But I do try. So with that said, I don't fault you. I mean, you're only human. Good or bad. But I also don't respect you. And I don't care if that's good or bad. You see, you are no MLK. You are no Jesse Jackson. You are nobody to me. You're just another dying king with a perm. Just a little more political. And that just means you're a little unhuman than us humans. And now, let me be human by saying